Absorption of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates in human diet are mostly present in the form of polysaccharides, which can be starch, fiber, and glycogen. Now, these polysaccharides are broken down into more simpler forms like mono and disaccharides by the process of digestion. After digestion, these mono and disaccharides are mainly absorbed in small intestine. To be more in particular, they are absorbed in small intestine, jejunum part of small intestine. After their absorption, they are distributed through blood to all the tissues. There are two types of mechanism of absorption for monosaccharides. One is active transport, the other is facilitated diffusion. Active transport is energy dependent, that is, there is involvement of the expenditure of energy during this transport mechanism. Facilitated is energy independent. Both active and facilitated are required for the absorption of monosaccharides from intestinal mucosa and kidney tubular cell. Facilitated is mainly required for the transport of glucose or the monosaccharide from mucosa, that is intestinal mucosa, to the blood and to various body cells. Firstly, active transport mechanism. This is also called as sodium dependent glucose transporter. In short, otherwise called as SGLT. This is a type of symport mechanism. That means both sodium and glucose enter into the intestinal mucosa in the same direction. Coming to the location, this SGLT is mainly located in the luminal side of the intestinal cell. This SGLT has two entry sites. One for sodium and the other for glucose. After the entry, this sodium is coupled with the sodium potassium ATPase. The entered sodium will be exited outside in exchange with the potassium along with the hydrolysis of ATP. The glucose that is entering inside or absorbed into the intestinal mucosa is transported into the or absorbed into the capillary surface with the help of glucose transporters that will be discussed in the facilitated diffusion. Now, this sodium and glucose that was told, the sodium is absorbed or transported down the concentration gradient, whereas glucose is absorbed against the concentration gradient. There are two types of SGLT transporters, SGLT1, SGLT2. SGLT1 is mainly required for the absorption of monosaccharides from the intestinal mucosa, whereas SGLT2 is mainly required for the reabsorption of monosaccharides from the kidney tubular cells. Facilitated transport, as already explained, this is energy independent. The absorption of glucose occurs along the or down the concentration gradient with the help of a transport carrier carrier or a transport protein. This is mainly required for the absorption of fructose, pentose, myo-inositol, glucose and galactose, whose concentration is more. Coming to the location, this glucose transporter is mainly located in the capillary surface of the intestinal mucosa. The glucose that is entering inside along with the sodium will be transported or absorbed into the capillary circulation or capillary surface with the help of the glucose transporters. There are different types of glue transporters. They are located at different sites. GLUT1 is located in the RBC, kidney, brain, retina and placenta. GLUT2 is mainly located on the big organs like intestine, liver, beta cell pancreas. GLUT3 is located on the neurons and brain. GLUT4 is located in the skeletal muscle, heart and adipose tissue. GLUT5 mainly located in the small intestine, testis, sperms and kidney. This is mainly required for the absorption of fructose. GLUT7 is located in the river endoplasmic reticulum. So coming to the summary, there are mainly two types of absorption of carbohydrates. One is active and the other is facilitated. Active is mainly energy dependent. Active is mainly energy dependent, whereas facilitated is mainly energy independent. Both of them are required for the absorption from the intestinal mucosa as well as the kidney tubular cells. There are types of active mechanisms or absorption are through the sodium dependent glucose transporter mechanism, whereas types of facilitated diffusion are through the glucose transporters. This is about the absorption of carbohydrates. Thank you.